إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. My brothers and sisters, dear brothers in Islam, there is something we need to remember. A reminder, of course. A basic foundation, yet again, of one of those things we commonly forget or we get distracted from, that we ignore many of times or we just seem to deny or to realize. And I observe this in myself and in others, that the dunya is always our priority and we're always forgetting this one basic fact, that we need Allah. No doubt, in reality and in truth, He is all we need clearly. And Allah has no need for any of us or any of His creation or anything for that matter. Allah says, إِن تَكْفَرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ وَلَا يَرْضَعْ لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ وَلَا تَزِرُوا وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى ثُمَّ إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ مَرْجِعُكُمْ فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Allah says what means, if you disbelieve, then verily Allah is not in need of you. He likes not disbelief for His slaves. Allah does not want us to disobey. He does not want us to disbelieve and commit kufr. He hates this for us. But if you disbelieve, He's not in need of you. And if you are grateful by being believers, then He will be pleased with you. No bearer of burdens shall bear the burden of another. Then to your Lord is your return. And so He will inform you what you used to do. Verily, He is the all-knower of what is in men's chests. ثم قال الله يسأله من في السماوات والأرض كل يوم هو في شأن. Allah says what means, and whosoever is in the heavens and the earth, they beg of Him. They're in need of Him, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every day He has a matter to bring forth. Every day Allah brings forth some matters, giving honor to some, disgracing some, giving life to some, giving death to some. Just remember, when you turn to other than Allah, when you are in need, and we're not talking about, hey brother, can you help me move this box or take my car to the shop or whatever it may be. But when in need of help, of guidance, of comfort, of solace, of protection, all those human needs that are true human needs, and you turn to shaitan, when you turn to those forbidden things, the alcohol, the drugs, the gambling, the music, the violence, and the likes of these things, then you have lent your soul to shaitan. And when the time comes for shaitan to be blamed and back you up, he ain't gonna be there for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, لَقَدْ ضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. Allah says what means, He indeed led me astray, meaning the mankind will say, He indeed led me astray from the reminder from this Quran after it had come to me, and shaitan is ever a deserter to man in the hour of need. We know shaitan will not come, that he will run, he will flee when you try and say, this one told me to disbelieve or to worship other than you or the likes of these matters. Allah says, كَمَثَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِذْ قَالَ لِلْإِنسَانِ أَكْفُرْ فَلَمَّا كَفَرَ قَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, this is the example of shaitan who tells the mankind to commit disbelief. And when mankind commits disbelief, he'll say, I am free from you. I fear Allah, the Lord of the worlds. Allah says, reminding us and warning us, الشَّيْطَانُ يُعِدُكُمُ الْفَقَرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Allah says, what means, shaitan, he threatens you. He makes you fear poverty. He makes you fear it. So much so you'll do anything to just not be poor. And he threatens you with poverty and orders you to commit fahisha, to commit wrongdoing, to commit evil deeds. Whereas Allah, He promises you forgiveness from Himself and bounty. And Allah is sufficient for His creatures' needs. Allah is the all-knower. Allah says, Ya ayyuhan nas, antum al-fuqara'u ila Allah, wallahu huwa al-ghaniyyu al-hamid. Allah says, what means, O mankind, it is you who stand in need of Allah. You, mankind, we need Allah for everything that we need. But Allah, He is rich and free of all wants and needs, worthy of all praise. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. And Allah said, what means? And Allah, He stands not in need of any of the alameen. Allah doesn't need mankind. He doesn't need the jinn. He doesn't need the angels for everything to happen and to roll out and to be decreed. Yet we need Him, and only truly Him. And the anbiya, the prophets and the messengers, they always turn to Allah, begging from Allah, in need of Allah. Look at how Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he explained to the disbelievers who were going to idol worship. And he told them, it is Allah الذي خلقني فهو يهدين. It is Allah who has created me, and He who has guided me. Allah is the only one who can create, and Allah is the only one who can guide to the straight path. والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين. And it is Allah who feeds me, and Allah who gives me drink. وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين. And it is Allah who gives me cure and remedy when I am ill and I am sick. والذي يميتني ثم يحين. And it is He who will cause me to die and then will bring me to life again on the day of resurrection. وَالَّذِي أَطْمَعُ أَن يَغْفِرَ لِي خَطِيئَةِ يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. And it is Allah who I hope will forgive me my faults on the day of recompense, on the day of resurrection. Our father, Prophet Abraham alayhi salam, may Allah's be peace upon him, Khalil al-Rahman, the intimate friend of Allah, affirming that without a doubt, the food, the drink, the sustenance, the cure, any need comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are words of total reliance upon Allah, words of a true believer. Allah said, وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَلِيًّا وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ نَصِيرًا. Allah says, what means, Allah is sufficient for you as a wali. Allah is sufficient and enough for all of us as a protector. And Allah is sufficient as a helper. ثُمَّ قَالْ وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا. So put your trust in Allah. Put your trust in your Lord, the one above the seven heavens and the earth. And sufficient is Allah as a wakil, as a trustee and a disposer of all affairs. Listen to this nasiha from Ibn Qudama, rahimahullah. He advised one of his brothers. He said, أَعْلَمْ أَنَّ مَنْ هُوَ فِي الْبَحْرِ عَلَى لَوْحٍ لَيْسَ بِأَحْوَجِ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَإِلَى لُطْفِهِ مِنْ مَنْ هُوَ فِي بَيْتِهِ بَيْنَ أَهْلِهِ وَمَالِهِ. Look at this beautiful advice Ibn Qudama, he gave, rahimahullah, to one of his brothers. He said, no, that a person in the ocean who has no one or nothing in sight, all he has is a plank of wood to help keep him from drowning. This person in the ocean on a plank of wood is not more in need of Allah and His kindness than the person in his home surrounded by his family and his wealth. Many of us would think, I'm in my home. I have security. I have an alarm. I have my money here. I have my family. I am definitely less needy than the one who's in the middle of the ocean and there's no one to help him. And this is an error. He said, no, the person in the middle of the ocean, on a plank, all they have is a plank of wood, is not more in need of Allah and His kindness than the person in his home, surrounded by his family and his wealth. Thus, if you comprehend this in your heart, then place your dependence upon Allah, like the dependence of a drowning person who does not know of any means for safety except Allah. This is how the true believer lives. The true believer acts, the true believer believes. We should put our trust and reliance in Allah because we are in need of Him and He has no need of us. أَقُولُ قَلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ اِذُوَ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبُكُمْ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, my dear brothers in Islam, Allah has no need for us. Allah has no need for our prayers. He has no need for our wealth. He has no need for our charity. Some people give in charity thinking, I'm doing Allah a favor. I'm doing the masjid a favor. I'm doing the school a favor. I'm doing this brother or sister a favor. Allah got no need. He has no need for us in any way. Not for our prayers, not for our wealth. He has no need for our fasting or our hajj. All of those deeds only benefit you. Whether you, we though are all in need of Allah. Whether you are strong or weak, rich or poor, in the middle of an ocean or in the middle of a mansion, equally we all need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our life, with our death and after our death, for our firmness on Islam, having istiqamah, that we stay steadfast upon this deen, for our sustenance to be wholesome and pure, from our rizq, our provisions, our wealth, and what we eat and drink and the likes of this, for our health. Anytime we have that, it is from Allah. Your hands, your sweat, your energy, your fatigue, your sleeplessness has nothing to do with the success you have, the money you have, the home you have, the cars you have, the property you own, anything else. All of it comes from the one you are in need of, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So remember this, and you may just be the most successful when it matters most on the day of resurrection. We will remind ourselves with a hadith that we mention often, but we need to remind ourselves of it even 1 hour from now. An Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma qal, kuntu khalfa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yawman faqal, ya ghulam ihfad Allah yahfadak, ihfad Allah tajidhu tujahak, idha sa'alt fas'al Allah, wa idha ista'ant fasta'in billah, wa'alam an al-ummata law ijtama'at ala an yanfa'uk bi shay' lam yanfa'uk bi shay' إلا بشيء قد كتب الله لك وإن يجتمعوا أن يضروك بشيء لم يضروك إلا بشيء قد كتب الله عليك رفعت الأقلام وجفت الصحف. This hadith which we have, which is authentic, it's a Hassan Sahih hadith in the Sunan of Tirmidhi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, and this was from Abdullah ibn Abbas, who said, I was behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, when he was on his mount, O young man, I will teach you some words. Be mindful of Allah. Allah will protect you. Be mindful of Allah and you will find Allah in front of you. Not physically, as we know Allah, He affirmed in His book that He is above the heavens and the earth, the seven heavens and the earth, above His arsh, separate from His creation. But Allah's aid, His strength, everything will come to help you, to protect you, to guide you. If you ask only of Allah alone. And if you seek help, only seek help from Allah alone. And know that if the nations were to gather together to benefit you with anything, they would not be able to benefit you except with something Allah wrote for you. And if the nations were to all come together to harm you with something, they would never be able to harm you with something except for something that Allah wrote against you. The pens have been lifted and the pages have dried. Ikhwani fillah, my brothers in Islam, 50,000 years before the creation, Allah, He khalaq al-qalam. He created the pen. فَقَالَ لِلْقَلَمْ أَكْتُبْ. He told the pen, write. قال القلم, it said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يا ربي وربي ماذا أكتب؟ Oh my Lord, what should I write? قال أكتب مقادير كل شيء حتى تقوم الساعة. This authentic hadith in Sunan Abi Dawood, Allah clarifies that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam clarifies that the first thing Allah created was the pen. He told the pen to write. The pen said, "What shall I write?" And Allah told the pen, "Write down everything that's going to happen until the end of time." All of this was decreed. So nothing can happen without Allah's permission. Nothing can help you without Allah's permission. Nothing can harm you without Allah's permission. We need Allah. All of the creation needs Allah and only Allah. هو الرزاق, He is the provider. Al-Basit, the grantor of extensive provisions. The one who has extensive provisions, this is from Allah. Al-Wali, the protector. Our Mawla, the supporter. Al-Wakil, the trustee and the disposer of all affairs, our guardian. Al-Nasir, the helper and the one who helps. Al-Samad, the self-sufficient of all of the creature's needs. Al-Mannan, the beneficent bestower of bounties, the one who is tremendous in giving. Al-Mannan, Al-Kareem, the generous one to all of creation. Wal-Akram, the one who's generous especially to the believers. Al-Muhaymin, the trustworthy and ever watchful witness, the one you can rely on, that he knows the good you do, and he knows why you do it, and he knows the hardships you go through. Al-Qayyum, the self-subsisting, the one upon whom everything depends. Allah is all we need, without a doubt, and the one by whom all is attained if He wills. So let us realize this once and for all. Stop inflating our egos to think that we are the ones needed by others, or that Allah needs us in some way, as if we are a gift to the world, or that you need other than Allah Rabbul Alameen. So rely on Him completely. Our Prophet ﷺ used to make a dua, and we left it for every family to take one copy, put it on your fridge and remember it. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, whoever says this dhikr, afwan, 7 times in the morning and 7 times in the evening, Allah will grant whoever recites it, 7 times in the morning, 7 times in the evening, whatever he desires from this world or the next. And this hadith has been authenticated in the Sunan of Ibn Sunni and Abu Dawood. So it is hasbi Allah. Allah is enough for me. Allah is sufficient for me. La ilaha illahu. There is no one worthy of worship except for Him alone without partners. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتْ. On Him alone do I put my trust and do I rely on. وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. And He is the Lord of the majestic throne. May Allah make us be of those who realize that we need Him and He does not need us, and benefit us with guidance upon it. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. سبحان ربك رب العزة لما يصفون, وسلام على المرسلين, والحمد لله رب العالمين, وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.